In this video, we will find out maxima of the function. Maxima, that is the maximum value of any function using PSO method. PSO, that is particle swarm optimization method. So we are using here PSO method to find out the maximum value of any objective function. Here you can see in this question paper, first question, find the maximum of the function fx is equal to minus x squared plus 2x plus 11 in the range minus 2 to 2. Lower bound we have minus 2, upper bound that is 2, using PSO method. So we will use here PSO method to find out maximum value for this function and use 4 particles. So for simplicity we will use here just 4 particles, value for n that is 4, with the initial position, and for each particle initial position is given x1 position, that is the first particle position, minus 1.5, x2 that is second particle position, 0.0, x3 that is third particle position, 0.5, x4 that is the fourth particle position, 1.25, and for one iteration we will do the calculation, and weight inertia value is given, that is 0.8, coefficient c1 c2 2.05. So you can see here we have given objective function and we have to find out maximum value for this objective function. Range is given here minus 2 lower bound, 2 that is upper bound, and the position for the 4 particles, for the first particle position minus 1.5, second particle position 0.0, third particle position 0.5, fourth particle position 1.25, and you can see all the values are within range. We need the values, that is the position for each particle in the range. You can see right now all the values are in this range, and for calculation the value for weight inertia is given, that is 0.8, and the coefficient c1 c2 value we have 2.05. so when we are asked to find out minima or maxima for any objective function, the objective is to identify the point for the objective function domain where function reach its lowest value, that is minima, or highest value, that is maxima. And we can use different techniques to find out the minima or maxima for any objective function. So in optimization problems, we are using here objective function, and for this objective function we have to find out either minimum value or maximum value. So here we have minimization problems and maximization problems. In minimization problems, the goal is to identify the value for the variables that make the function to reach its minimum value, and in maximization problems the goal is to find out the value for the variables that make the objective function to reach its maximum value. Maximization problems are often transformed into minimization problems. For example, you are trying to maximize function fx, then it is transformed into minimization function, that is minus of fx. After that we will apply the optimization technique. So we can transform the maximization problem into minimization problem by considering the negative of the objective function. For example, you can see here negative sign minus of fx. It does not change the nature of the problem. Even we can solve maximization problems directly without any transforming into negative of the function. It depends on the technique that we are using. So when we will solve the maximization problem direct without any transform, then we need to be careful during the comparison when we will compare the personal best or the global best values. During that we will consider the maximum value instead of minimum value. So here we are using particle swarm optimization method to solve this problem. Here you can see different steps used in this method. First we will define the objective function. After that, for each particle, initialize the position, velocity, evaluate their performance using objective function, update local best, that is personal best position, update global best, that is the best among all. So here we will compare the fitness value, then we will update local and global best. After that we will start the main loop. for the first iteration. So here for each particle, we will generate new velocity, new position, and after that, using objective function, we will evaluate new solutions, then new solutions, then we will check whether the new solutions are within bounds or not. After that, we will update the new local and the global best position, and in the end we will display the best position and the fitness. So here we will do this for the two iterations. So first step, define the objective function. So we have given this objective function range, we have -2 to 2, and step two, we will initialize the position and velocity for each particle. Position for each particle is already given in the question paper. X1 position -1.5, X2 0.0, X3 0.5, X4 position 1.25. Initially, we will consider the velocity for the each particle 0. Weight inertia value is given, that is 0.8. Coefficients value is given, that is 2.05 for both. Step 3, using this objective function, now we will calculate fitness value for each particle. So we have 4 particles. Now for 4 particles, calculate fitness value. Here we will solve this maximization problem directly without any transforming into minimization problem. So we will consider, so in comparison, we will consider the maximum value. So here right now for the first particle, position is given -1.5. Put the value here, x we have -1.5, it's square, then 2x, 2 into -1.5 plus 11, then the value we got here -5.75. Next, for the second particle, we have given position 0.0, put the value here, and we got the fitness value for the second particle, it is 11. For the third particle, position is 0.5, put the value here, and we got the fitness value 11.75. for the fourth particle, position is 1.25, put the value here, and we got fitness value for the fourth particle 11.93. Now for each particle, we will update their personal best position. So personal best position right now, you can see it is same for each particle. After that, we will update the global best position. Global best, that is best among all. Here you can see when we calculated the fitness value for four particle, here we are doing the direct maximization. So we will consider the maximum value as the best value, and you can see the maximum value among all is for the fourth particle, that is 11.93. So we'll consider this particle position as the global best right now. After that, in step 4, we will update the velocity and the position for the each particle. First, we will update this for the first particle. Its position, we have -1.5. You can see the equation. You can see using this equation, we can calculate velocity. Weight inertia, 0.8. Initial velocity is considered 0. That is here, 0. Then we have any random value, 0.3. You can take any random value within range 0 to 1. So here we consider first random value 0.3. Then we have coefficient C1, that is 2.05. After that, the personal best for the first particle is same, that is -1.5. Then we have its position, that is -1.5. Plus, we will consider any random value. So again, consider any random value within 0 and 1. So here we have 0.6. After that, second coefficient 2.05. Then we have G best, that is the global best, that is the fourth particle. Fourth particle position, we have 1.25 minus particle position. Here it is -1.5. And we got the value for the velocity for the first particle, that is 3.3825. After that, we will update the new position for the first particle. So in previous position, we will add the new velocity. So here, previous position for the first particle, we have -1.5, and we generated, and here we calculated velocity. So add this velocity in the old position, and we got the new position for this particle, that is 1.88. Same we will do for the second particle. Here, second particle position, we have given 0.0, put the value here. Velocity we got for the second particle, that is 1.537. Now for the second particle position update. So in the second particle, older position, add the new generated velocity. So here we got the new position for the second particle, that is 1.537. Now we will do for the third particle, put the value here. that is its position value we have right now 0.5, and we got the velocity 0.1537. at now calculate its new position. So we got the new position for third particle 0.6537. here now we have fourth particle, you can see G west, and its position is same. So we got the velocity 0 and new position is still same. Now you can see the updated velocity and the position for each particle. For the first particle 1.88, second particle 1.53, third particle 0.65, fourth particle that is 1.25. Now we will ensure the new particle position is within given range, that is in the -2 to 2. So you can see right now for each particle position is in the range. So here you can see we generated velocity, calculated new position. Now we will evaluate the new solutions using the objective function. So here we are using this objective function. Now using this objective function, we will evaluate, it means we will calculate the fitness value for new position. First particle new position 1.88, put the value here, we got the new fitness value for the first particle 11.23. second particle position 1.53, put the value here, we got the new fitness value 11.72. for the third particle new position 0.65, put value here, we got the new fitness value 11.83. for fourth particle position is still same, so we got the same fitness value. After that we will update their personal best fitness value. So here for this we will compare old and new fitness value for four particles. Here you can see the old fitness value for four particles, we have first particle 5.75, the new we have 11.25. so we will consider the best solution. Right now the new solution is better than the older one. We need the maximum value. For second particle, again new position is better. New position is better. For third particle, again the new position is better, and fourth particle is same. So you can see for the personal best, now we considered the new value for each particle. Now we will update the global best, that is best among all. So in previous iteration the best solution we have 11.93. now we will compare this solution with the new solutions. If any new best solution be obtained, then we will consider that. Right now, so for first case, so here you can see we have old value for the global best 11.93. they will compare one by one with all. So first we have 11.23, still the older one is better. Now we'll compare this with second particle, again 11.93 is greater than 11.72, so it is better. Now we will compare with third particle, again the older one is better. So right now again the global best is fourth particle, that is 1.25. so we'll consider this position as the global best position. After that we will check the stopping condition. So here we will check the stopping condition, repeat the step from step 6 to step 9, and the value you obtained in the last iteration is the best value. Now we will perform second iteration. So here step 6, update velocity and the position for the each particle. So again we will update the velocity and the position for each particle. So for first particle you can see the new position we got 1.88, and here you can see velocity, that is the old velocity we have 3.3825, that is added here, plus random value, you can take here any value. Then we have coefficient, put the position, global best right now we have 1.25, it's still same. We got the new velocity 3.489, calculate new position, add calculated velocity in the older position, we got the new position for the first particle, that is 5.36. same for the second particle. Now for the second particle the new position we got, that is 1.53, put the value here, and we got the new position for the second particle 2.41. same for the third particle, new position 0.65, put value here, we got the new position for the third particle 1.695. For the fourth particle, new position, that is 1.25. Right now you can see the older velocity we added here, and we got the new velocity here and the new position for the fourth particle, 1.043. After that you can see here now we got the updated velocity and the position for each particle. This is right now for the second iteration. Now we will ensure the new solutions are within range or not. So if any particle go beyond range, then we will set its position to nearest boundary. So right now you can see here the new solution we got for the four particle, and first and second particle position, you can see this is exceed. So here it is not given, it is not within the given range. So for second, so for first and second particle, we will set the position that is to near to the boundary. Here we will consume. So here we will set the position for first and second particle to, and then you can see for third particle, fourth particle. After that, we will evaluate the new solution using objective function. For first and second particle, you can see we got the same fitness value. For third particle position, we have given 1.695. Put the value here, we got the new fitness value for the third particle, that is 11.51. Put fourth position, that is 1.043. Put the value and we got the new fitness value for the fourth particle, 11.99. After that, we will update the personal best. So here we'll compare older and new personal best for each particle. Right now you can see here for first, old P best for old P best fitness value, new P best for fitness value. And here we are doing the direct maximization, so we will consider the maximum value. For first particle, you can see the older one is better. For second particle, again, older one is better. For third particle, again, older one is better. For fourth particle, you can see the new p-best we got, it is high fitness value, so we will consider this. So now you can see the personal best for each particle. For first three particle, we consider the old. For fourth particle, the solution is bit improved, so we'll consider this one. Now we will update the global best. In the previous iteration, we have global best, that is the fourth particle, having fitness value 11.93. Now we'll compare this fitness value with the new solution one by one, so, and we will check which one is better. So we have right now G best fitness value 11.93, compare with new solution. Here again, the older one is better. Then we will compare with the second particle, again the older one is better. Then we will compare the G best with third particle, new solution, you can see older one is better. Now we'll compare this with the fourth one, bit improved, so we'll consider this, that is new position for the fourth particle, 1.043. so here you can see we updated the global best, so we will display the best position and the fitness value. Right now the best position we have fourth particle 1.043, and the fitness value we have 11.94 after two iteration. Then we can again check stopping condition. When the stopping criteria is met, stop and display the best solution, else we will repeat steps from step 6 to step 9. So in this video we used PSO method to find out the maximum value for this objective function, and we have given four particles, their position is already initialized. Then we evaluated their performance, updated their local and the global best, then we calculated new velocity, new position for each particle, and after that the comparison, and in the end we display the best solution that is found, fourth particle. So that's all about this video. If you have any questions, you can comment below, and thanks for watching this video.